Hello children, welcome to a 9th English class. Children, today let's learn a new lesson called Whatever We Do. Isn't it, don't you think that the name of a lesson is something unique? Whatever we do, correct? Thus, in everyday, day-to-day life, whatever we do, it seems that we have done it and it should be more better or it could be much better than what we have done before. Right, the thought will comes to you. Right, example, you take a example of a, suppose you have given an exam, simple class test thing, that simple class test you have given. After giving an exam, you think that what exam I gave, that could be more better than this, or I could have write the exam better than that. Okay, that will comes to your mind, isn't it, children? Don't you think so? So that is why the name of a lesson is also same, whatever we do. So whatever, in the sense, now at present what we have done, and after that we think that it could be even more better than the previous one, or we could have done more better than that. Okay, so this is lesson about that, the action which we have already done. Okay, and it tells that how it could be better than earlier one. Okay, so I'm going to read the lesson. So let's see the lesson line by line. Whatever we do, let's try to do it better. Our action, our words, whatever it is, let's us try to do it better. So what it means, children, see, whatever we do, okay, let's try to do it better. So as I told, when I gave the example of a writing an exam, you have done it very good, okay, you have done it very good, but because of the time limit, you may not able to reach to the that extent which you are expected. Is it clear? Because of the time limit, you are not able to extend your writing to the expectation level. So that sadness or dissatisfaction will be remaining in you. So here the thing is that when we are starting any work, the thing will comes to our mind that last time I have done like that, this time let's do it better. Whatever we do it, that should be better than earlier one. Okay, whatever it is, let's try to do it better. Success, they say it is journey and not a destination. So having a success in a work, it is like a journey and not a destination. What do you mean by destination, children? Destination, it means the sense aim that we want to reach, or the point of our achievement that we want to reach. So if suppose in middle of the life we get success, it doesn't mean that our achievement has completed and that is our end over there. Do we think like that? No. The success which we get in our life, it is just like a journey. Okay, but still it is there to continue to reach our destination. Destination in the sense what? Destination in the sense that we can say as a final goal that we want to reach in our life. Okay, and even though we have reached to 70, 75 also, you see few of the people, they are not satisfied with their achievement or their work. They still want to do something, they want to read, they want to acquire the knowledge, or they want to do something good. That is because they think that whatever I achieved, a name, a success, a fame, it is just part of my journey, not a complete end. So here a writer says that though if you have got success in your life, that is not a complete work, that is just part of your journey. A destination is still to reach. We say progress also is also a journey and not a destination. As success is not a complete of your life, or the success is not end of your life, like that if suppose you are progressed or developed in a life, that is also not end of your life, or that is not your destination, because a progress as well as a success, it is a just part of your journey. What do you mean by dead progress, children? Progress in the sense, think that first you have one small hotel, okay, in the corner of the road you have just one hotel there, and nearly 5 or 6 members can stand and eat their food like a mobile canteen, okay. And as you develop, you progress, you will open a 5-star hotel, okay, and that is a progress and not it is a end or not it is a destination of your life, okay. Therefore, we need not to feel complacent that we are doing fine. We must constantly be on the lookout for the better performance. So, if suppose you think that I have achieved, I have successed, I have progressed in my life and finished, I have done everything. If you think like that, that is the foolishness of your life, because that is not a complete life. Who knows, in the age of a 35 children, you may see the success or a progress, okay. After 1 or 2 years or a 3 year, if you completely collapse, your progress will come down, your hotel will shut down or it will be closed. Where is your progress? What happened to your success? Correct? So here writer says that if suppose you are achieved a success or you are progressed, don't think that it is the end of your destination. No, there is a still way to reach your destination. Okay? See, we must constantly be on the lookout for the better performance. If we want to thank someone, I say thanks. But suppose I say thanks a lot, wouldn't it be better? So here the writer, to make you more understand about destination, he will give the example that if somebody will help you, you will just say thanks to them, okay. Just example here, you are helped by someone, children, okay. In return you will say them to a thanks, okay. It is very difficult situation in the sense, when you are writing an exam, okay, in the last 5 minutes, okay, in the last 5 minutes, still 5 more questions is there to write, okay, and only 5 minutes is left out. In that 5 minutes, you know, all are busy because to complete their answer, because time is very limited. So in that moment, your pen ink get empty and you want a pen. Spare pen you don't have, so you want a pen. If you are not writing, what will happen? Your 5 marks will be went, and that is very important to get 100 out of 100. Okay, and in that moment somebody will see your difficulty and they will help you, children. Okay, after writing the exam you will thanks them. Thank you. You will say thank you. Okay, and your writer say, instead of saying thank you, thanks a lot. The word thanks and thanks a lot mean a lot. Okay, yes. Lot means what? Much. So the adding the word lot there, it will join your thanks a lot. Means where you are delivering a bundle of thanks, thanks a lot. It means better, right? So here writer, why it has compared? Because you have achieved, you have success, you have a progress, one side. Okay, and if you think it is enough, that is your foolishness. So that you have to add a lot to your progress as well as a success. Okay. Thanks a lot. Would it be better? He is asking. Instead of saying your thanks, you can add thanks a lot. Okay. Depending upon the time and the situation, we can try and improve this even further and say, I am very grateful to you, or you have been of great help. I thank you from the bottom of my heart, and also on. So see, there are different ways there you can deliver a thanks to a person, one who helped in a difficult time. Like instead of just saying a thanks or a thanks a lot, or you can say that you have been a great of you, great help, or I would like to thank you from the bottom of my heart. If such words, if you add to your thanks, it will be more better and it will be more meaningful. Not only more meaningful, it has more weightage than a thanks. Okay? The same way, as I told, here a writer is comparing your progress and success, where you should add other work which can increase your progress as well as a success. Okay? Then, this is a simple case of expressing a gratitude. Here, a writer has given an example of a delivering a gratitude. But when we think a little more, we can learn to do or say things in a better way by giving some thoughts or an action or a speech. So, here writer says that here just example I gave you where you can say a thanks in a better manner. Whereas, not only a speech, there are action is also there which can add meaning to your speech or to your word. Is it clear? Not only a words, there is also action which can add more meaning and more weightage to your words to show your gratitude. I had an appointment with a person who was senior to me in our SY company. I was a bit late and trying to make amends. So, he gave one more example that writer had an appointment with a person who is senior. Is it clear? He had an appointment with a senior in his company, but it was a bit late and I'm trying to make amends. So, see, he had an appointment with a senior. Means he had some work or he wanted to ask something with a senior, so that he has took the appointment. Why we will take appointment, children? Just because we have a work. Our work has to be get done. Clear? Our work has to be get done. For that sake, we will take an appointment or we want to meet that person. So, when we have an appointment, we have to need of that person. In that case, we should not make that person to wait. But here, writer says that, though I had an appointment, I need of that person, I made that person to wait. Because he has mentioned here, I was late. So, he wanted to make amends. What do you mean by amends? Amends in the sense, some changes or changes. Change how? That he want to ask a sorry for making him to wait. That is what your amendment, okay? I said, I'm sorry, I made you wait. Okay? He will go and he will apologize that I'm sorry, I made you wait. Then in return he said, oh, it's okay, he said. And added, it is a pleasure waiting for you. I felt flattered. So see that person there, that was his gratefulness. Though he was waited for him for a long time, instead of getting angry, he said that, oh, okay, it's okay, no problem. But it was pleasure to wait you. Pleasure in the sense, it was like happiness. If suppose somebody will tell that, I will come and I meet you, okay? And that person to whom you like very much, in that case, no matter what a time, how long it is, you are ready to wait. Only if you like that person or you admire that person, then you are ready to wait for a long time. So, here a person, one who has waited for a long time, he said that, no problem, I will wait for a I waited and it is pleasure to wait for you. Hearing that, he was flattered. Flattered in the sense, somewhere he felt happy and he started to fly inside, okay? One might argue that other person might have said it without any thinking. Even then, I would say that I like to hear such statement, unless of course they were said sarcastically. See, sarcastically in the sense, for example, now he said that it is pleasure to wait you, okay? When we meet the person, they are few way willingly say that, okay, I'm eagerly waiting for you. It is pleasure to wait for you. In the sense, that person, in case if they admire us, if they like us, they'll say that, no problem, I can understand your situation so that I waited, no problem. It means that the person know our situation, they understood us, so that they are ready to wait. Okay? In some other case, they say that okay, you are late. Okay, I can understand, and it is pleasure to wait. Ironically, they say, or sarcastically, they say. What do you mean by sarcastically? Vengyavagi. In Kannada, they will say no, vengyavagi. Oh yes, you are very big person. Inside what they will think? Yes, you are very important. CM, PM, you are. So that I have to wait. Inside they will say, but they cannot express that outside openly. So that okay, it is pleasure to wait. That sarcastically also they can say vengyavagi. That can also they can say. So here writer was in confusion that yes, though I made him wait, he was cool and he said that it is pleasure to wait. Yes, I am happy to hear that. But whether he said from heart or it was a sarcastically he said. Okay. When we speak about saying or doing better, a question arises about comparison because better usually follow them. Wise people say that we should compare ourselves with our own self. I should compare my performance of last year and see whether I am doing better or not now. So here writer says that when we are comparing our work, we should compare our work with our own work, not with somebody else's work. Why do you see? We will eat a food which we require or which we can digest, that only we will eat. Right? Yes, that is our food habit. What we like, which is good for our health, that only we will eat. We won't eat for other sake. Or he said that is good for health, so that I eat. No, not like that. Right? What we require, that we eat. Same the way. Our achievement, our performance should be compared with our own work. Our progress should be compared with our own work, not with somebody else's work. So, if you are doing some work today, you compare your today's work with yesterday's work, so that you can set a target. I have done that one and it should be better today. So, set a target by comparing your own progress, not by the performance of other. Okay. So it is like how you know children, when you get your answer sheet, example I am telling, you have to see that what mistake you have done in your answer sheet, where you have lost your mark. Instead of that, what we will do, we will see our answer sheet and we will compare with other. There you got mark, here ma'am took my mark. That is not a good comparison. How it should be? You have to see where you have done a mistake and where you have lost a mark, and that mistake you should not do it next time, so that you should not lose the mark. Is it clear? That is a good example. Okay. One of the way in which we can do better is adding the word to our action and also adding action to our words. Let me tell you about an incident. So your writer says that we should add an action to the word, okay, and to our action we should add a word. What it means? Suppose you would like to tell that thank you, okay, or thanks a lot. That is a word. For that you have to add an action. How action? Thank you, right? Isn't it? That is an action. If suppose instead of doing this namaste, this is only an action. Or a welcome. Just because instead of giving a shake hand, you can say hi, how are you, right? So here a writer says that you have to add a word to your action, and to your action you have to add a word. So both action and word should go together, okay, not alone. So he gave an example. I was waiting for a lift, okay, a writer one day, he was waiting for a lift. The lift came down and I found that two fellows. Shouldn't I say person or even better gentleman? See there, look at there. He has used the word fellow. Right? So when he used the word, in mind he will think that I should not use that word fellow. It should be gentleman. There is a correction, right? How we are expecting respect from other, the same way children, we have to respect other. That is a mannerism, right? when you won't give the respect, then how you can expect the respect from other? So here, when the writer used that word fellow, then he thinks that, I should have used the word gentleman. Okay? So when he was waiting for a lift, when the lift door opened, two gentlemen were inside the lift. What they were doing? Started removing the packets which were fully occupied the lift. So the two person, they are standing in lift. They had some luggage and the items which were fully spread in the sense the full lift was occupied by their items. So as soon as door opened, the two person noticed there that this writer want to come inside the lift. But the thing is that there is no place for that writer to get inside. So what they have done, observing that, they didn't ask him or he didn't say anything. They started to pick the word and keep it in one particular place so that they can give a place to a writer. That was noticed by the writer, okay? I noticed that they did the job fairly fast, giving me an impression that they did not want to delay me. So very quickly they gathered all the items and they made it to come inside. They don't want it to waste the time of a person, one who is waiting for a lift. Okay? That was understood by the person or a writer who was waiting for a lift. That is a good mannerism, right? We should not tell them, you please take your item, I want to stand there. That is a bad. It was like a slap, right? That's why we should correct our mistake before someone tells you. Is it clear, children? We should correct our mistake before someone tells us. So, I noticed that they did the job fairly fast, giving me an impression that they did not want to delay me in a little while. They finished the job and I got into the lift and went to my training center. So, he get inside the lift and he went to the training center. In the class, I mentioned this incident and asked the trainees to explain how this particular situation would have been rendered better. So the same example he will give to his student or the trainees. And see, today I met with this incident. If suppose you are in that place, how you would have handled the situation? Okay, he will arise the question to the student or a trainees. A couple of trainees in a sense, two person, one who are receiving a trainee, they said that, did not mention that the two gentlemen who were removing the packet could have said something like this. 1 minute, sir. We will finish in no time. Nice answer. Don't you agree? See, as the writer said that, the word and action should go together, not alone. Here, a person or the persons, one who are in the lift, what they have done, they did not say any word. They have just done the action of a gathering the words, gathering the item. So here a trainee says that instead of just gathering the item, they could have said that 1 minute, sir, I'll finish in no time. So they could have said the word that just wait a minute, I'll finish it fast. Nice answer. Don't you agree? It would have made such difference, but other trainees said, you could have thought of lending helping hand to them. So instead of doing just work, if they added a words to me, I could have understand their intention, that what they wanted to tell me. Okay, so the intention is here that instead of only doing action, we can add a word, or just a word we can add a action. That is what your writer say. Okay, then you go to shop and ask for something. Most often the shopkeeper or salesperson reaches out to item you want and hand it over to you. So okay, this is another example where writer tells that when you go to a shop to buy something, what will happen, what we can see there, a owner doesn't go to bring the item. He will tell to a salesman, go and get the shampoo bottle. Correct? Then what he'll do, that salesman, he will go to the particular place where the shampoo has kept and he will bring to you. Correct? So no words, nothing. Suppose here we say just two words. Yes, sir. Say, correct? When the owner says to salesman, go and get the shampoo, he will rush. Salesman will rush to that place to get the shampoo. And what we expect? What we expect? Whether that salesman will bringing my order or he was going to get somebody else order? Because two buyers are going stand. I asked shampoo and you asked soap. He said two items at a time and no answer, only action. What you can understand? Correct? Instead of that, he would have said, yes, sir. That means that we are satisfied. Okay, he was going to take a item. So that is why the action and words both comes together. Another example you give, in posh restaurant, the waiter should not say good morning or some such things and then ask for your order. But you noticed how the waiter behave in most of the restaurant. In spite of that, the fact that the food and the ambience are quite good. So here another example is that, think that when you goes to posh restaurant, okay, why do you go to restaurant? Okay, why we will go to have a food? Okay, for the restaurant is meant to have a food. When we go and stand there, sit there, have you noticed waiter will come and stand near to you? Okay, if he just stand near to you, will you order? Will you order? No. What we are expecting? We are expecting that he should ask, sir, what do you want? Which order you like to please? Correct? That is the action of coming and standing, and in return he has to ask. Though he know and we know we came to eat the food, both the action comes that, sir, what do you want? What order you want to place? Correct, children? So here he gave the example that in the restaurant, how the waiter will take a order with action as well as a word. Even in our day-to-day life, both the action and words should come together. They usually come and stand near you, expecting you to place the order. Suppose they say just word, yes, sir. Correct? He will ask, you see that he will come and ask, sir, what do you want? What can I give for you or what can I do for you? Right? Instead of that, if suppose he come and stand, or if he asks, yes, what do you want? Yes, sir. Will you order? Yes. Seeing his face only, what will get? Will get angry, not a hungry. Correct? So that is the mannerism we have to treat the people. Next, another example is you. Doctors treating patient can make their job much better if they choose to talk nicely to the patient. Okay? See, when you goes to a clinic, what doctor will do? He will do the only action. Okay? He will test. Correct? Here writer says that instead of just doing the action, a doctor could have a word. He could have speak nicely. Right? A word here or the words there, most of the doctor are serious or even in the stern. So he says that when you go to clinic, the doctor won't speak much. They will give only the action or the remedies. Instead of that, they could have speak better. They could have speak little cheerful so that patient can feel better, relaxed and relieved. Okay? Probably they may imply that they are doing serious work. But what the doctor thinks that I am doing very serious work. I cannot speak. If I speak, I cannot hear the heartbeat. I cannot count the heartbeat. Like that they may think. But talking nicely and reassuringly is also a part of a treatment. So your writer says that as we conscious of treating, even the words is also a treatment. You have to speak gently, politely, so that will also work as a treatment, isn't it? Is it said the a couple of friendly words for a doctor or even smile can go a long way in making patient feel better. So he gave that. So the words, not only a medicine tablet, even the words can make a patient sometime to feel better. You think that a patient is having severe stomach pain and is suffering a lot. Only treating and giving a tablet, he won't come to know what he is feeling. Instead of that, you say, okay, you're having a stomachache. Okay, it will be cured. It can be cured. Don't worry. It will take 2 days. It will take 1 day. Or let's see what will happen. Nothing to worry. Such words give a courage to the patient, isn't it? That is why here writer say both the action and the words work together. Okay, that is the magic of a word as well as a action. Okay, children. Today I'll stop here. The remaining part I'll continue in the next class. Till then, what you have to do? You have to read and you have to get the meaning of a difficult words. Okay, children. I'll meet you in the class. Till then, take care.